In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. My friends, in love and in sorrow, we have come together to celebrate this funeral mass for Emily Weinwurm. May the Father of mercies, the God of all consolation, be with you all. As in baptism Emily put on Christ, so in Christ may she be clothed with glory. Here and now we are God's children. What we shall be has not yet been revealed, but we know that when Christ appears, we will be like him, for we shall see him as he is. And this is our Christian hope. White pall, symbol of Emily's baptism in Christ, will now be placed under the casket by her brother Paul and sister-in-law Patricia. Is now placed onto the casket. Again, reminder of our belief in the Lord Jesus and all he did for us.
You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign lands, and all will understand. You shall see the face of God and live. Be not afraid. I go and I will give you rest. If you pass through raging waters, in the sea you shall not drown. If you walk amid the burning flames, you shall not be harmed. If you stand before the power of hell, and death is at your side, know that I am with you through it all. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will give you blessed are your poor, for the kingdom shall be theirs. Blessed are you that weep and mourn, for one day you shall laugh. And if wicked tongues insult and hate you, all because of me. Blessed, blessed are you. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will give you.
God of mercy, look kindly on your servant Emily, who has set down the burden of her years. As she served you faithfully throughout her life, may you give her the fullness of your peace and joy. We give thanks for the long life of Emily, now caught up in your eternal love. We make our prayer in the name of Jesus, who is our risen Lord, now and forever. Amen. Maybe see it at this time. Our reading from the Old Testament today will be read by Lisa Blake, Emily's niece.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. Do not fear, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name, you are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and through the rivers, they shall not overwhelm you. When you walk through fire, you shall not be burned, and the flame shall not consume you. For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. You are precious in my sight and honored, and I love you. The word of the Lord.
Under his wings, your ref.
his faithfulness your shield, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand.
You need not fear the terror of the night, nor the arrow that flies by day. The thousands fall about you, near you it shall not come,
and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn,
make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm
of his hand.
For to his angels he's given a command to guard you in all of your ways. Upon their hands they will bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone.
And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn,
make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm
of his hand.
Our New Testament reading will be read by Patricia Weinwurm, Emily's.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Philippians. Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I will say, rejoice. Let your gentleness be known to everyone. The Lord is near. Do not worry about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with the thanksgiving, let your request be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds in Jesus Christ. Finally, beloved, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is blessing, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence and if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Keep on doing the things that you have learned and received and heard and seen in me, and in God, the God of peace, will be with you. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. and the truth and the life, says the Lord. No one comes to the Father except through me. Alleluia. 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 Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the crowds, "Everything that the Father gives me will come to me, and I will not reject anyone who comes to me, because I came down from heaven, not to do my own will, but the will of the one who sent me. And this is the will of the one who sent me, that I should not lose anything of what he gave me, but that I should raise it on the last day. For this is the will of my Father, that everyone who sees the Son and believes in him may have eternal life, and I shall raise him on the last day." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Maybe seated at this time. We welcome all of you as we gather in prayer to celebrate the life of Emily Joyce Weinwurm. This is a sad time as we mourn her passing from this life, but it is also a celebration of her life, of her faith and belief in God, and a celebration of her new life with God in eternity. And during this time, while some family is unable to be here because of the pandemic, we are live streaming this funeral mass so that they could at least view it, view this celebration. On behalf of Father Frederick, Father Paul, and the people of St. Thomas Aquinas, I want to extend to Emily's family our deepest sympathy, to her sister, Carol Johnson, again, who is unable to be here, her brother and sister-in-law, Paul and Pat Weinwurm, her two nieces, three great nieces, three great nephews, and several cousins. As the obituary stated, Emily was born on December the 12th, 1933, in Oneonta. The family moved to Binghamton in 1937, and she attended local schools and graduated from North High. And she was one of only 20 women accepted into Cornell's new School of Industrial and Labor Relations and graduated in 1956. And she immediately commenced her career with the New York State Labor Department, starting as a trainee in Syracuse, worked as an interviewer in Binghamton in 1963, was promoted to supervisor in Albany and manager in Plattsburgh in 1966. And during her 23 years in Plattsburgh, she also served on the advisory committee to the Clinton Essex County BOCES and the advisory committee of Clinton Community College. And after retiring in 1989, she returned to Binghamton, and she became active with the Tri-Cities Opera, serving as secretary and vice president of the TCO Guild for many years. Emily was also a Republican committee woman and served several years on the Binghamton Zoning Board of Appeals and was appointed by Mayor Bucci to represent the 4th District on the City Council in 1997. You know, Emily was very proud of her accomplishments and would speak often of her experiences, especially the opportunity she had to attend events in Washington and other places related to her work. And she was active certainly in the communities where she worked and lived and wanted to give back to her community in whatever way she could. She was truly a dedicated public servant and was well respected by those she worked with. She is honest, forthright, and genuine in her work and in her community involvement, and really gave thoughtful insights into situations that were presented in either her work environment or on committees. She loved the opera, was very knowledgeable about different operas, and she certainly had her favorites. She knew I enjoyed opera as well, and when there was a special opera presentation on PBS, she would always alert me. She also loved to travel and spoke often of her travels with her family to Europe, Austria, Hungary, Germany, and other places. And she remembered very vividly the places that she visited. And she would give so much detail that you could almost imagine being there. And she loved to cook and to entertain, and would have the priest over during the summer for an outdoor picnic, and certainly all of us enjoyed that time together. Then there is the annual Christmas gathering where, again, we would come together with other members, other family, friends, and we just have a good time together. You know, she always had something for everyone. And then there were those special Slovak cookies that she made for the holidays. I just can't think of the name right now. But they were always, we always had a plateful at a rectory, especially around Easter time. And it goes without saying that she loved to shop. We all know that, right? QVC, of course, and maybe other channels too, I don't know. I'm not sure how they're going to survive without her. And she always got the very best. And her family can attest to that, as they were the recipients, especially around the holidays and those special occasions. Emily was just a very delightful person, had a hearty laugh, loved her Mia and her bourbon, and she always adorned her outside with flowers and banners reflecting the season. Her faith was so important to her. She had her own special place in the front left side, just behind where Paul and Pat are, and Connie are sitting. And she had her little group around her, ones in the back there, Kelly, and they just enjoyed their time together, chatting before Mass and after Mass, and they really developed a very, very wonderful relationship. And I know that Carol, who could not be here today, used to send her little notes at the nursing home, and hopefully the nurses read those notes to her. She just wanted to do something. She wanted to send her flowers, but they couldn't. They didn't allow flowers. But again, she just wanted to do something, and just to let her know that that people were caring about her. I think today we find comfort in her life of faithfulness to God, to family and friends, and in the word that we heard proclaimed today in our scriptures. From the book of the prophet Isaiah, so many things are passing, but not the word of God. He says, "Do not fear, for I have redeemed you. Whatever you go through in life, I will be there for you and with you, for I am the Lord your God. You are precious in my sight, and I love you." We saw how that belief helped her throughout her life, and especially in this past year when she was dealing with some health issues off and on. But she would always remain hopeful and would not give in. She was a fighter and valued her life as well as her independence. Though she did appreciate the help of neighbors and of friends. An Eagle's Wings is based on Psalm 91. It is a psalm of trust in the Lord, knowing that God is our refuge and our strength, that the angels will guard us from all harm, and that one day the Lord will hold her in the palm of his hand. You know, this is what really gave her hope. And this hope is reaffirmed by St. Paul, who says to us, "Rejoice in the Lord always, and keep on doing the things that you have learned from me, and the God of peace will be with you." You know, as we look at the life of Jesus, certainly this is what he experienced in his own life. The Father's love for him, and as God's Son, he gave himself up unto death and was raised up. And by his rising, dying and rising, we are now children of God. Again, this is the love that God has bestowed on us, and one day we shall see him as he is. This is the mystery that Emily knew in this world and now celebrates in that new world where everything is made new. And the good news is heard in the Gospel of John when Jesus says, "This is the will of my Father, that everyone who sees the Son and believes in him may have eternal life, and I shall raise him on the last day." Emily is now in the hands of God, the God who shaped her life and gave her purpose. She was united completely with the God who loved her into being and loves her still. As for us, we both find both comfort and challenge in the words of the ancient writer of wisdom, "Those who trust in the Lord shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love." Like Emily, we are called into relationship with the Lord, a relationship marked by trust and faithfulness, a relationship that will lead us to truth and abiding love. It is this relationship that is a place of healing and comfort, the place where mourning will turn to joyful remembrance. And all of you have your own special remembrances, those special moments when she touched your lives. She delighted in giving to others, whether it was preparing a meal, giving a gift, engaging in good conversation, sharing the things that were important to her. So be thankful for those special times, for in this way you give her honor. Later in the service, family members will offer some personal reflections. We ask the Lord to be with us and to comfort all of us who have loved Emily, and ask the Lord for the strength and love to be compassion and love for others. Emily, you have been a good and faithful servant. Enter now into the joy of the Lord.
God, the Almighty Father, raised Christ, his Son, from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save all his people, living and dead. And our response will be, "Lord, hear our prayer." For Emily, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, may she now be admitted to the company of saints. We pray. For our sister, who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, may she be raised up on the last day. We pray. For all the deceased members of Emily's family, her parents, August and Hilda, and brother Daniel, may they have the reward of their goodness. We pray. For Emily's family and friends, that the love they have shared be a source of strength and peace at this time of loss, we pray. For Emily's love of music, evident in the selections she chose for her funeral mass, give her great joy and peace. May the choirs of angels lift up her heart as they give praise and glory to our God. We pray. Emily's deep sense of loyalty and devotion to God, her family, to our community, and to her friends, inspired all of us. May we too live committed lives of self-giving, we pray. God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed brothers and sisters. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of redemption. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. When my way grows drear, precious Lord, linger near. When my life is on, hear my cry, hear my call, hold my hand, lest I fall. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. When the darkness appears and the night draws near and the day is past and gone, precious Lord, lead me home.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God our Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all, his holy church.
As we humbly present you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Emily, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life has changed, not ended, and when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Douglas, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for yourself. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O Merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
Remember your servant Emily, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who is united with your son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life,